In this video, I'm going to use this switch and load from Quickwire in order to make my connection so I can facilitate this new LED light fit my wife wants putting in the lounge. I've dropped down the ceiling rose and pendant. We'll have a look at the connections in there to see if it's using the two plate or the three plate method. And the safe isolation procedure has been carried out. I've done that many times on the channel, so if you want to see that, I'll leave a link for it in the description or it'll appear in the eye above my head. However, this video is all about whether this Quickwire bit of kit here can make it easier to make the connections for this LED light fitting. So let's have a look inside our ceiling rows. The first thing you might notice is we've got maybe one cable less than you expect. This is because this light here is the last one on the lighting circuit. So let's see what we've got. This side here, we've got the brown conductor coming down to our pendant with a blue conductor next to it, but note it's got some brown sleeving. So that is actually not a neutral, it's a switching line conductor. It comes in with a permanent line conductor, which is in loop, and a CPC. We've also got the permanent line, neutral and CPC, which brings our power supply in. So remember from our wiring diagrams, we're looking at this and trying to work out whether it's the two plate or the three plate method. Because we're using the loop terminal here, hopefully you've worked it out. It's a three plate method. So our power comes into loop, it comes down to our switch and then back on this one, which is blue with brown sleeve, which is our switching line. And on the other side of the fitting, we've got a blue neutral. So we're going to need to take these connections out and put them into our Quickwire connector. So here we've got our switch and load. Now you've got the power coming in, which we've got coming into here, but as it's the last point on circuit, we won't need the connections on the other side, which is the power out to the next room. So we're going to bring in our line, neutral and CPC and make our connections into here. On the other side, as I turn it round, we've got the switch one, so we'll have our permanent line and switching line connections along with a CPC going into here. And then our new cable, which comes down to our LED light or load, we'll have our switching line, neutral and CPC. And I've already connected that into the LED light fit and it just clips into here. So let's take the connections out of our ceiling rows and make them into here before we pop this into the ceiling and we can fit our LED light fit in. So this is our, what they call the power. So this is our permanent line, neutral and CPC coming in. There is no one going out. And this goes down to our switch, which brings the permanent line, switching line and CPC back. So we're gonna need to make our connections in the right part of this. So we're looking for, if I'm gonna do this one first, which is our supply into the fitting, they've called it power. And we need to strip this back and pop it into this Quickwire connector. We've seen these on the channel before, how easy they are. But I'll show you once again how to cut this back and just pop it into place. Rather than trimming these back to length, I'm going to cut them off and show you again my lovely wire strippers I've got. So I'm going to take this one and cut it off. Bring in my twin and earth strippers or my twin and CPC strippers. They're for flat cable up to 2.5. I've got a 22 mil is my first length. So I'll bring it in and just bring the grey outside PVC sheath down to 22 mil. I pull that. And just pull it off. Next one, the length is the end of the grey sheath to there. It gives me my actual conductor length that I need to strip off. The conductor length is stated on here between 15 and 17 mil. But if you use that as a barometer, so in other words, the grey PVC sheath at the end of the stripping tool, you get it right. We pull those off. And we've seen this before. Remember, this one needs to be the power one. So we've just got to get the polarity correct. There are three very small holes in there. They're going to line up when they almost self line up with it in there. But we must make sure we get the polarity correct. So those little three holes in there. So I bring it round. I've got neutral CPC in line. I've got it in the correct position. All I'm going to do is pop it into there. You can see through the window. I'm making those connections in the window. And all you do now is just push it into place. There you go, the power is connected now into this Quickwire switch and load connectors. That's the supply coming in. We haven't got a supply going out, so we don't need that section there. We can just click that into place. All we've got to do now is put the switch and load in. So I've got the switch here, we'll do that one next. So we've got the switch one now. So we've got switch line, line and CPC. So that's our permanent line connection and our switching line connection being one which is effectively blue with brown sleeving on it. We can take that off now because the connections are going to come into here, so you won't see those. And again, I'm going to cut it off and use those fantastic twin and earth strippers that I like so much. Once again, bring it into 22 mil. So line it up in the correct position. Just take your time, get it in the right place and just pull off the outside PVC mechanical protection, repeat the process again from a conductor length. We slide that one off, and now we've just got to make sure we make the connections correctly. So if I just pull that one up, I'm going to fold this one round. I've now got to make sure I'm the correct way round. Well, switching line is this side, so I'm going to be that way round, and I'm going to find the holes as I did before. It self-finds. Just check my polarity. I've got my switching line this side and my line connection that side. You probably can't see, so I'll just pull it back out a little bit. You can just see them there going in correctly. Push them, connection made for the switch. So I've made my fitting up already. So the wife chose this one. I've got my twin and CPC cable ready to be connected as neutral, CPC and switching line. So neutral, CPC and switching line. So when we come back to the quick wire connector, we turn it round. We can see we've got load. We've got an N for neutral, our earth symbol for our CPC and our switching line. So once again, it's just about making sure you get it in correctly. It finds the three holes that are in there. Like so, I've just checked, I've got my neutral on the correct side, CPC and switching line, and just push it into place. All it needs now is this connector to go up into the ceiling and obviously to fit my LED light fin. And then we can power up and see if we've got a nice new light fin. That was something different for the channel, but it links back into looking at whether it was a two plate or three plate method and using a different form of connections in order that we can install this new LED light. All it needs now is for the light to come on. And there we go. As always, I hope this video has been some help.